Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. In today's video, I'm going to talk about the new update that happened inside of ComfyUI, which brings native translation inside the interface itself. So there's no need for any third-party custom node. Previously, if you were using ComfyUI in a different language, most likely you've installed AI God-like translation, which was translating ComfyUI in real time. The moment something appears in the DOM structure, it will automatically translate it. But you might have noticed that it was introducing quite a bit of a lag because of the way it was translating it. Basically, the moment something gets added in the HTML structure, it has to do a scan, check what is new in that structure, and then it would translate it. Now with this native support, basically we have the languages already integrated in the web UI. You just need to select it and everything will be translated. Of course, as long as we have a translation for it. So if I go into my ComfyUI, I will need to click on the settings button here. Then click on ComfyUI here. Under locale, we have language. And right now you can see mine is English. So simply click on the drop down and then you will have Chinese. This is the simplified Chinese. Then we have Russian. Then we have Japanese. And the last one is Korean. So I'm going to choose Japanese here. And you can see right away it will say node definition updated. And then the UI, even the custom nodes here, which I've installed, have translation. Of course, it depends on that individual developer if they are adding support for it. So the settings page, as you can see, everything is translated. There should not be any problem. At the top here, that also is translated. This is the Q button. And then you can see the menu at the top here. Again, that's translated. We can do new, open, and then we have our undo button, edit, and stuff like that. Now, even on the left side here, where we have our Q button, that is also translated. The nodes, all of them, as you can see, as long as they have the support, they are translated. Right now, the ones which I found do not have any translation is this utils. We have the primary, the node, and the reroute one. But everything else, we have translation for it. So if I zoom in here, you can see that it has the native translation here, right? So you can see here, we have the translation. Now, of course, if the model requires English text, then you will still need to have your English text here. And similarly, if you are using a Chinese model, for example, then you will need to translate your English text to Chinese and then have a Chinese positive prompt or negative prompt here. Now, at any time, if you want to go back to the default, which is English, you can go back into settings, comfy, and then this here would be the locale language, and then we just need to change it to English like this. All right, so that was a quick update. By the way, there's also a few updates here. We have this tabs system that was added now. So instead of clicking on the workflows and then have all of your workflows here is stacked on the left side, it will be in the tab menu at the top. So as you can see, if you are lacking space, it will just grow and give you more space. Now I'll probably have a separate video on ComfyUI updates for the month of November/December. So look out for that video. This was sort of an special video only for those who uses subtitle when watching my videos. So as you can see, most people would watch it with English subtitle, but we also have Korean and Chinese, which get audio translation. So hopefully when you're reading the subtitle, you can go into your ComfyUI and change it into your native language. All right, thank you for watching until the very end. Have a good day ahead. Take care, and I will see you next time.